Hi Cancer, I'm Anisha. You can write to me at tarotbyanisha@gmail.com. You can also visit my website www.tarotbyanisha.com. And this is your monthly horoscope for October 2014. Cancerians, we begin this month with a Mercury retrograde, a total lunar eclipse, which is conjuncting Uranus. And we wrap up the month with Venus that is going to be entering Scorpio. We begin the month, Cancerians, with a Mercury retrograde, and that is happening from the 4th of October and it carries on till about 25th of October. That's precisely 3 weeks. And I'm sure we know the Mercury retrograde drill by now. Be extremely careful as far as your communication is concerned, be it spoken, written, emails, SMSs. It could get misconstrued and there could be less clarity. Seek clarity at all levels, even when you think that it is not required. As far as travel is concerned, for those of you who are going to be traveling in October, ensure that your schedules are in shape, that the flights that you are taking are the correct flights. There could be some amount of a chaos that you may experience during this time, since Mercury rules travel as well. For those of you who drive on your own, ensure that your cars are serviced, your bikes are serviced, you're carrying the correct documents with you. It's not advisable to be buying a big ticket electronic item during a Mercury retrograde, simply for the reason that you may not be having enough information on the product, or you may just find another brilliant newer version of the product right after the transit gets over, or there could be a small technical glitch as well over there. So be a little careful. Now, Mercury retrograde, this aspect happens about 3 or maybe even 4 times in a month, with a complete slowdown that happens. Now, technically, of course, no planet really comes back on its axis or orbit, or even slows down for that matter. But this is for the retrograde stationary cycle. When it is viewed from the Earth, it just creates an illusion which makes you feel that there is a complete slowdown. Plus the fact that Earth is moving at its own speed around the Sun, and which is different from the rest of the planet. So you just get a sense that, oh, you know, the planet has slowed down. Now, Mercury is going to be affecting a part of your chart that has to do with your emotional foundation. It has to do with your home. It has to, Mercury also retrograde is a time which is about revising, rethinking and redoing things, Cancerians. So a lot of you who have been in a bit of a rush to get things done quickly, and like I said, this has to do, since it's covering your emotional foundation, it's covering your home. It is asking you to step back and rethink, and it's asking you to rethink your course of where it is or what it is that gives you emotional security, and reset your bearings to make sure that you're really on the course that is intended. Do not hesitate to question fundamental values in order to get to the heart of what you really believe in and resolve internal conflict with what it is that that may arise. So if your fundamental values are not matching with your partner, or there's something that you drastically differ on, it's a time really to be coming out and talking and communicating more about it. However, since the retrograde is there, it could be a bit of a challenge and it could require a lot of effort on your part. So keep an open mind. Mercury also rules the lower mind, which means that it is the environment around us, what it is that we perceive, and in turn what it is that we relay to the audience. So you could feel, you may assume something which is not really intended. So seek clarity, and I think communication is the best way to iron out the toughest of wrinkles. Small insights can net you large gains, particularly in the future stability of your ship. And rock your own boat before others do, and you'll be better off for it. By the end, you may find a risk evaluation highly useful, Cancerians, particularly when you depend on others to evolve into what you will lean on in the future. So the key for you for this retrograde is to really look into your relationships, into your fundamental values, what it is that you want, what it is that you want others to evolve into, and is it what Is it that what you're reflecting or not is the key over here? We have a total lunar eclipse which is happening on the 8th of October and it is conjuncting Uranus. Now Uranus has a reputation of being the bad boy of astrology and he is this unpredictable, uncurtailed energy which causes chaos, disrupt things. And the lesser known thing about the Uranian energy is that it's extremely dynamic. It's inspirational to a certain extent, creative. And it gives a lot of courage because it allows you to take that risk with it. In fact, all the new technology that is there, it has to do, Uranus rules it. Also, the thing with comes along with Uranus is freedom. It's all about personal freedom. It is how it is and what it is that is really important to you and to what lengths will you go to achieve it. And for you, this is happening in a part of your chart that is happening in your house of career and reputation, which I think is really brilliant. A lot of you can expect some amount of accolades or an increased work portfolio. Now this has two sides to it. Again, unfortunately, that's how success comes. It could affect your personal life to a great extent. You may suddenly find that you don't have much time to nurture your closest relationships or to your personal relationships because the work is so much. And out here, the planets are also encouraging you to think that not to let ambition blind you so much, Cancerians, that you are just so caught up with making money or so blinded with the power and the money and the ambition that is coming to you that you just sort of neglect and forget about the personal side of it and say, you know what, that's not going anywhere. I need to be making money right now, or I need to be rising up high at my workplace. So strike a balance. This conjunct is all about striking a balance between your personal and your professional life as well. Those of you who are under immense, tremendous work load and pressure, this is also a great time. Rather, you should take this opportunity to spend more time with your loved one or with people who matter a lot to you. Venus enters Scorpio around the 24th, and this is happening in a beautiful aspect of your chart. So I think everything that we've been talking about, wanting to spend more time with your loved one, starts happening towards the end of the month, wherein that you are going to be seeking love actively, and it's happening in a part of your chart that has to do with creativity, it has to do with children, it has to do with love, with romantic love. So a lot of you are going to be, in fact, a lot of you thrive on romantic attention. You know, you are, it's easy and quite natural for a lot of you to have quick crushes. You quite love being the center of attention, having being involved, being in a relationship. You quite enjoy the entire love, playful side of it. And this time towards end of the month, it just gets more accentuated, and you could be feeling quite sensuous, and you will be indulging in quite pleasurable things. This there is a lot of amount of retail therapy involved as well, and now a lot of you could be going and buying some beautiful stuff for yourself, and you could generally be feeling quite beautiful and loved and pampered. And there could also be a touch of little bit of drama also around you. You will quite, if you're a woman, you could quite be playing the diva at this point of time and loving and basking under all the adulation and attention and the love you could be getting from everywhere. And if you're a guy, you could be feeling quite charming, or you will be quite charming towards your potential partner or towards your partner. And it's a very playful and a warm time for you as we end the month, Cancerians. So a brilliant month. Try not to let your ambition and the need and the urge to make money get the better of you. Ensure that you strike a great balance, Cancerians. Have a brilliant October. I'll see you again in November. And thank you so much.